just so you know, man, I'm probably gonna chop this up because you're probably looking at the continuance from last week's video that we did, that we unfortunately got stopped by because my camera was just, is memory is not acting right. All right, so now we're here in a new playing field with a new phone, new camera, and I just want to talk that shit. I ain't gonna lie. So let's get right to it. Ayesha Curry, motherfucker. Ayesha Curry, motherfucker. Right, so we're kind of talking about it a little bit. Right now we're just eating. I ain't trying to get too deep into it because while we're talking, because I want to get into here. Thoughts real quick for the peeps.
Yeah, so
the conservative thoughts.
Yeah, so if you don't know what's going on, she was in the
Red Table
Talk. Red Table Talk, right? Which is Smith.
The Smith family.
Yeah.
Basically.
So
the women.
Like, yeah, so it's like this conversation, right? And she was with her sister in law, I think her mom in law also was there. So she was saying, you know, like voicing her opinion on different things, how, you know, Steph is kind of like a really friendly guy, so girls be coming on to him and whatnot, he doesn't even notice it. But they were like, they be trying to lust on him, like trying to get at him, right? And how for her, you know, she feels some type of way because they don't do it the same way. They don't give her the same treatment, right? Like they don't try to get at her. And so that's where we're on right now. So for me, I don't know, man. I guess as a girl, like, you know, and maybe as a guy as well, you kind of need that confidence boost of like feeling attractive. Because that's what she said. She said, I don't feel attractive, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's like, you know, like, you know, like the whole idea of I don't want it, but it's nice to know that I can get it. Like, you know, like guys, we have that and we can relate. I think it's just weird when a girl says it because it's a double standard. Like, if she says it like, I don't want it, you know, but I want to know that I can get it. Like, I want to feel sexy.
Mm-hmm.
Like, a guy, it's like, you're married to Stephen Curry. Like, you know, for that one person in the world that lives under a rock and doesn't know who Stephen Curry is, he is perhaps one of the best players in basketball right now. Perhaps the best 3-point shooter in the world ever. Right? He just got $200 something million from the Warriors. He is a devout Christian. He is a now he's a film producer, right? Because breakthrough is him and Devon Franklin.
Mm-hmm.
He's a little bit of everything. Right? And overall, most people will tell you that he's an overall nice guy. Like that's a consensus,
yeah.
Right? Like he's a family man, beloved, whatever. And so, you know, I would understand why a guy wouldn't come up to her.
I mean, okay. So, that was like the, I guess like the, you're looking into like trying to understand
her.
Yeah, I
understand where she's coming from.
And I could kind of like not really understand that myself because the my whole thing is that you're married.
Yeah.
So you're already married, right? And you're saying that you're basically saying that you want other guys to take shots at you. That's basically what you're saying. You get me? So I get what you're saying. Like, yo, the reason why guys don't take shots because she's married to Steph Curry, which
makes
sense.
Yeah, guys are dirty.
It's like,
so
nobody's
hitting
on like Michael Jordan's wife, assume, right?
Like guys are dirty. So let's be honest, marriage don't mean nothing to a guy.
Right.
But when you're married to Stephen Curry, you it's like,
I get where you're coming from.
It's insecurity for a guy to come at you.
Well, like, I mean, she did say that. She said like it's like a little bit of an insecurity, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I get, you know, the whole courageous thing about being able to say it and stuff. My whole thing is, like, you know, we from the outside look at it like, yo, like, why are you not satisfied? That's really how we're looking at it. You get me? Like, this is from the outside looking in because I really don't know how the household is, all of that shit. Like, I have no idea. But, yo, you have it all. Like, you literally, you have your own little cooking show that I don't know if you could, maybe you could cook good. I don't know, whatever. You know what I'm saying? You got a husband. Again, as list go down, Steph Curry is like the perfect guy,
yeah,
right? Again, like a fucking Christian guy, multimillionaire.
He's light skinned.
I think at those 2 points, I say, like, it's a wrap. Like, any guy is getting a girl at that point.
He's light skinned and he has like green eyes or something.
Right. Like, he's like, I don't think, at least me personally, I wouldn't consider him like a pretty boy, but I get what you're saying. Like, there's certain features
to him that make him like a good looking guy.
I don't get why, you know, again, I don't think that it's such a big deal as people are making that out to be, because I feel like it's a moment that she just went ahead and just said, yo, you know, like, yo, this is just like something that's, you know, been going in my mind. This is how I feel about it. You get me? Which I completely understand. So I wouldn't bash her for it. You know what I'm saying? But just saying, like, I could understand though why people are like, yo, like, why aren't you satisfied? They're like, why do you feel the need to want another, you know?
Yeah.
And my whole thing is going to be just social media. I think it's social media. I think that we live in such an age now where it's like, yo, if you're not getting a compliment, if people aren't feeling you, they're like letting you know, then it's like, yo, I'm not worth anything. You know what I mean? Because the moment girls started getting those likes and whatever hormone in the brain mm-hmm. started to like, oh shit, like I like this feeling. Is like that universe that you now live in with social media is now comes out into mm-hmm. real life. You get me? And you feel like, yo, if I'm not popping out here, then am I validated out here? And then that's exactly where people make the ultimate mistake of trying to seek validation through other people. You get me? What other people think about them. And again, her statement may not be that deep to people. You don't realize, like, but it kind of is. Like, subconsciously, it is. Like,
yeah, because I mean, the worst part is that she said, "And I don't feel attractive. I don't feel sexy." That is where I was like a little cringy, because it's like, that's a personal thing. Second of all, you have a husband. Like,
but that's so, validation. Yeah, no, she's saying, yeah. She's saying she doesn't feel attractive because people aren't hitting her.
External validation. So that's where that's the one part that I was like. You know, because I can understand you have insecurities. We all do. Mm-hmm. But the whole thing of I don't feel attractive because dudes don't come up to me is like you need the validation of another guy that, first of all, that is not your husband.
Exactly.
Second of all, that is not yourself, your own self-esteem, right? So it's already, because I mean, a husband is one thing because you guys are in a relationship, you would want to find you attractive.
Right.
Right? But you want some random guy to find you attractive so that it can make you feel good about yourself, that is bad. Definitely. And that is in a way, like you said, it's a reflection of our, you know, society just driven by social media and attraction and likes and loves.
I mean, look, people seeking validation from other people is nothing new. Let's get that one out of the way. That shit's old. I remember being little and my mom, just going to the doctor, to the dentist, my mom would be like, yo, bro, you're not going to the doctor dressed like this.
Yeah,
like, go put on some shoes. Yeah, you're not going in sandals. You're not about to go in shorts. You know, go put on some jeans or something like that, right? Because you don't want to go out and you don't want to be like the mom who other people are like, oh, like her kid, just like,
oh, if your kid is behaved bad or whatever.
Yeah. Like, you don't want to be the parent, like, you know, like, because you care too much about what other people are saying. So validation is not nothing new, right?
Of course.
But I feel like, you know, Instagram, like, you know, it's just put a big ass magnifying glass on everything. It's made shit a lot bigger. So now it's like you really, honestly, if you post a bit, like, I remember I was having this conversation not long ago. If you post a picture on your social media and you don't get as much likes, because this is something that influencers, yeah, most people will go ahead and delete it. If you really not, if you put a picture up and nobody likes that picture, I guarantee that picture's probably not staying up.
You taught me, and it was like the whole, like, oh, there's certain hours and days that you post,
yeah,
because you know you're gonna get the prime view.
Exactly, like, you know, that's when people are on, yeah. Like, you want people to, like, look at this shit, you want people to like it. Yeah, when you open up that Instagram app and you just see, like, a big ass number where the little heart is at or whatever, like, that, you know, you get like the comments, the hearts, mm-hmm. people have social media or whatever, you see that shit, is like that shit, I'm telling you, like, a study shown, I forgot what the fucking hormone is, I don't fucking remember that, like, it
endorphins?
Just endorphins, I guess. What was that hormone? What's it
do? Well, endorphins is when
excitement and, like,
yeah. Positive, so your endorphins get kicked in,
right? Exactly. Like, so when people see that shit, your endorphins kick in. It's like, you start to, when people don't realize it, but you start to build that habit of, like, I mean, like, over time.
It's like a high.
Yeah, it is a high. It's literally a high. Like, you post a bunch of pictures, get a bunch of likes, you feel good about that shit. You post a picture, get no likes, you're like, fuck. You post a picture, people start roasting you on that picture, you're gonna feel like shit. You're probably gonna take that picture down, you're gonna block your comments, whatever. But at the end of the day, I feel like social media's made it to this, to get to this point, because you shouldn't feel like, you know, unless stuff isn't making you feel beautiful, or, and I mean, again, for this from the outside looking in, because, like, when you see them, they be silly, fucking, yeah. You know, doing, like, their shit or whatever. So it doesn't look like they're, like, you know, like, not fucking with each other. Like, I mean, yo, like, the guy keeps you pregnant. Yeah. I mean, like, I don't, it looks like, you know, it looks like a good relationship. It looks like one of those relationships that I guess you would consider, like, goals or whatever. You know what I'm saying?
Sure.
So, like, when you say
and you can say that whole ghost thing, because they started, like, young. Like, really.
Right.
You know, so.
Yeah, it's in high school. It's high school, right? I don't know. I think
it's high school or college. Well, I don't know, but they were young, like, mad young. Right, so they've been at it together for a minute. So now that he's in his 30s, you know, they've been like 10, 12 years plus.
Yeah.
But I mean, I think you nailed that right on the head. Like, the danger here is that we find validation in external forces, like, whatever external force that is. Mm-hmm. Like, your self confidence, your self worth, has to be internal. Has to be. You know, you are who you are. You're confident in who you are, regardless of weaknesses, regardless of flaws. You just find, you know, the strength in who you are, because you're gonna suffer if you live by other people's acceptance, right? Because the moment they reject you, you'll die from it. And the same thing, even in the relationship, if you live by your husband's acceptance, then you won't be able to give your husband the wife he should reserve or whatever, and he can't give you the husband because you guys have insecurities you guys don't get through. right? And a lot of times insecurities have nothing to do with the external. It's all internal, but we profess it that it's an external thing. Oh, he doesn't make me feel sexy. No, no. It's because you feel insecure, so the fact that he didn't compliment you, now you think he doesn't find you sexy.
Yeah. It's like the Cat Williams joke about... Cat Williams has a joke that he talks about girls, right? Uh-huh. Talks about how girls will tell guys, oh, you're fucking with my self-esteem, right? And then he snaps. He's like, bitch, it's an esteem of your motherfucking self. How can I fuck that up? It all has to do with what you think about you. You know what I'm saying? Which it's a funny joke, but it's real as fuck. Self-esteem. It's real as fuck. You know, like people like, I have suffered with self-esteem issues. Most of the time, it has nothing to do with what you directly think about yourself. It has to do with what you feel other people think about you.
Yeah, you allowed it to be a window through which you see people.
Exactly. So literally, self-esteem no longer... You're not even talking about self-esteem no more. You're literally talking about other people's esteem about you, I guess. That means like... Because it's literally turns into that.
And at that point, it means you're saying that their opinion values is more important
than what you do with yourself. For sure. Yeah, for sure. That's literally how people start to live
their lives. Which it's sad because then we end up consumed by Instagram. You know, oh man, they didn't compliment me. They didn't like my picture. Then I guess maybe I'm just not that popping. I'm just not that nice. I'm just not that attractive. Exactly. Or no guy slides into my DMs. Like, they don't find me attractive.
Exactly.
Like, yo, because look, you want to be, if you're the type of girl that's trashing or bashing Ayesha, and yeah, you trip because no guy's lying to your DMs, is the same concept. It's the same idea. You're mad because you're not getting attention, which is not how it's supposed to be.
And all of this is, it just goes down to that attention. You want attention. And the thing that like bothers me, honestly, is when people try to sugarcoat that attention part. It's like, well, you know, like we all want to feel like... Fuck up, man. Like, don't even... When people bring it up like that already, it's like, man...
Try to sugarcoat it.
Like, yeah, you're trying to, like... It's almost like people know they're wrong and they don't know how to confidently... Because, you know, when you confidently feel like somewhere, you're like, nah, man, it's because blah, 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 right? And then when you really don't know...
You're trying
to
go around
it? You'd be like, well, I don't know. You know how it is. You know, it'd be like really,
no, please tell me how it is.
Exactly. Like, tell me how it is because I just don't understand that. You know what I mean? Like, look, we had this whole... thing, I guess will probably be like the first half of this video, right? When we're initially talking about like, yo, if like for example, look, man, I've gone out of my house in a full flower tracksuit, right? You'll see that in the intro to this podcast every time, right? Most people will be like, nah, that's too flamboyant.
Yeah, that's too
you know what I'm saying? And that's cool, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's fine. That if it's for you, that like, you feel like that shit is not you. That's exactly why your ass don't got that. You feel me? But if somebody got that shit on, you know what I'm saying, and you want to hate, that's cool too. You have every right to do that. But best believe that just because you want to rank and talk shit, I'm not about to be like, nah, bro, now I gotta go change, nigga. Give me your car keys, nigga, so I can go change real quick. You know what I'm saying? Because shit, you know, because this shit's ridiculous. This shit's ridiculous. It makes no fucking sense. You need to be confident with your... Like, if you decide to pull up, and looking like a construction worker, somebody who just rode a bike, somebody who just came from working out. Yo, embrace that look, because that's who you are. That's what you decided to wear that day. That's what you need to be. You need to be that for yourself. You know what I'm saying?
I ain't gonna lie. Yo, you just took like 10 shots all at once.
Nah, I never take shots, man. What are you talking about? Why are you laughing so much, man?
You're worse than Charlamagne, like you.
I'm not gonna lie, bro. That gym right there's about to cry, man.
You see, I'm not gonna cry.
She was about to punch me in the neck and then put you in the neck.
You guys are my biggest motivators. You guys are
some haters. Haters motivate me. You know what I mean.
Wait. She said you guys are my biggest motivators and you guys are haters.
You guys are haters. You're my biggest motivator.
Oh, okay. How can you change that sound?
You motivated from hate?
Because he felt uncomfortable.
Okay.
Yeah.
So that's why you want to go change?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
I said that, and I made it clear.
All right, so let's talk about that. Let's do group counseling now. We're talking about Ayesha Curry. Talk about group counseling. Let's make this a group counseling.
So it all started.
Look how nervous Chris looks right now. He's about to start sweating.
I told you I was able to punch you in your balls, man.
I think that mic is still
picking up. You can pick it up. You can definitely pick it up.
All right, man.
You have to cut that out, though.
Look, man, point is that whatever that whole thing is, you know, I read, like, excerpts also from, like, from apart from watching, like, the whole Red Table Talk. And I can understand both sides of the coin. I can understand it, but I can't understand it. because one part of you is, okay, you want the attention because, you know, when you're young or when you're older, whatever, you want to feel like you're wanted. Again, understood. But at the same time, at this point in your life, you know, you have a family, you have your own businesses. Those are the things that, you know what I'm saying, and I guess, at least in my opinion, should be like what you're worried about. You get me? Anything extra, it just makes no sense. Like when people talk shit, right? Like I told you, you know, when people are like talking shit and like, you know, you're spending time on that, you have nothing going on. It's because you have nothing going on. Because you're wasting your time and energy to talk about other people.
And, you know what I'm saying? And if you are on the receiving end and you let that get to you, then you are wasting your time taking into account somebody who has nothing going on for their life because they're so consumed in talking crap that they don't actually proceed to live their own life. Mm-hmm. Right? But you know what? I think one interesting thing that I thought about and I saw a bunch of people talk about it is how she, on whether she thought about it or not, put out unnecessary pressure on Steph. Because if you play ball, you know the homies will take anything, especially when you're in the playoffs, any ammo they can take. Yeah. You know what it is? And now you gotta deal with the stress of like your career, as well as with the words that now people can use against you.
Yeah, exactly.
So I found that funny because, you know, it's like, all right, you can, if you're not careful with your words, if you're not wise with how you express things, then you can create certain tension and extra stress into your marriage or relationship and into the other person because now they feel like they have this burden. And Steph responded in a very, you know, right standing, protective answer, right? He defended her and, you know, honored her and respected her and whatever, celebrated her. But you don't know internally what he's feeling, though. So it's like...
Did Steph snap you last night?
He went off, bro.
Yeah?
He went off.
How many points did he have?
He had 31, but he scored 0 points in the first half. So he had 30-something in the second half alone. And then he had like 21 in the fourth quarter.
Wait, so he scored... You said 0 points in the first quarter.
First half.
Oh, first half he scored zero,
zero points. 0 points. On the second time he scored here.
Thank you, Ayesha. Thank you, Ayesha.
So, James Harden, if you mad because he's staying home, blame Ayesha.
Yeah. Blame Ayesha, bro. All right, man. So I think it's a wrap. Yeah. I think it's a wrap.
So what's that? We're wrong? Are we wrong, girls?
Maybe. You probably disagree. I'm gonna tell you you're wrong, anyways. You know what I'm saying? But I think that, you know, again, if you're a smart person, you know what I'm saying, which I think you are. I think, you know, all 59 of you are at this current moment. I would assume that you kind of got the drift of what we're trying to say. You know, this is not focused on Ayesha Curry. This is just a hot topic. You know what I'm saying? That we could kind of bounce off the whole concept of self-worth and self-love and love yourself, because if you love yourself, you're gonna love others. Because if you don't love yourself, then you can't love other people.
You're right. Facts.
You know what I'm saying? Facts. So hope that you got that. Hope it got to your little hearts, your little minds, you know what I'm saying, and start building up something. You know what I'm saying? So once again, man, you already know what it is. I'm down. We'll be back again next week with another one. So stay tuned. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you guys for supporting. Appreciate the comments. Appreciate the likes. My endorphins go up, you know, when I get the likes. Appreciate the subscribers. You know what I'm saying? And we thank y'all, man. Until next time, love.